you for this period, I'd like to reintroduce an idea that Martin had yesterday in his keynote, where he was trying to say, let's think about community 2.0. And so I just want to scope out what that is, the way that we see what we're trying to work on and improve, and then get your input about what you would like to see community 2.0 look like. The goal behind everything is to find ways to empower teachers. And so we're thinking of the Moodle community as certainly being very significant to students. But as Martin said, we can't do this without teachers, and teachers are the ones that we're most familiar with and we can reach and we can provide tools for. So currently, if you are in the Moodle community realm, you might be familiar with the forum discussions at Moodle.org, which have been there, as Martin said, since like 2002. And and I don't know what your experience was or is with them. They tend to get pretty technical pretty quickly, and there's not a lot of teaching conversations that are happening there. There have been kind of spurts where we've tried to do more of that, but it just, frequently the tool falls back on people needing help and people needing technical help. Then we've got Moodle.net, which is really all about courses and content, that opportunity that some take, but not many, of pulling down courses that other people have contributed and using them for themselves or modifying them. And even some folks, writing courses and sharing that with a larger community. We also, as you know, have learn.moodle.net, which is a place where our MOOCs live, and where people have, many people have come and taken classes and created their own courses to practice in and get feedback from the MOOC leaders. We have our docs.moodle.org, which many of us spend a lot of time in just trying to figure out how things work. And then we have tracker.moodle.org, which is super technical but fascinating as we learn like what developers are doing, how they envision solving problems, and what that looks like. So this has been truly functional, right? These pieces have taken Moodle in 12 years to 100 million users around the world. And that's nothing to sneeze at. But at the same time, I think, a number of us feel that it's, including Martin, that we're not the destination that we could be. And so how can we do that? How can we get there? Yesterday, in his keynote, Martin mentioned these points. He said he'd like to see a professional development space for educators and learners. So if we think about this, instead of thinking about like six satellite areas, let's just imagine that we go to Moodle.net and we log in as ourselves, and there's something there for us that helps us be professionals, right? And maybe courses that we take from Moodle or from other places. Maybe we write courses for each other to help each other with things. He likes the idea of there being a Moodle account, just like you have a Google account or a Microsoft account that lets you into this space and maybe authenticate in different tools in different places. He likes the idea that this world, this new world, is connected to, if your administrators approve it, to your own Moodle site, so that your teachers could immediately be connected to a larger community that can truly help them solve problems. So you have a new science teacher at your school. They're certainly a professional because you've hired them. There might be materials that your community has already provided for them, but why not reach out to the world and see what else is there? So he sees this as being a connection that's possible. He likes the idea of us finding each other, by region or by subject or by language, so that those connections can be further refined. He's very interested in integrating open repositories. Now, we know there are some very good open educational resources that are out there that have some high-quality tools. And the methodology there usually is to go to those spaces, search, you know, download from there, upload it into Moodle if it's already a Moodle course. If not, you might have to do some magic to make it a Moodle course. But he really wants to do those connections for us so that we can really just drag and drop things in and use them in our own courses. And he's also very interested in this idea of crowdfunding, you know, tools for developing new open content. So if you just like, what is that great program, Teachers for Teachers, that where you can hire each other to write course materials in the U.S.? It's very popular and it's very powerful because instead of, if you're not wholly into the camp of OER, it's a great way to make a couple bucks while serving each other and supporting each other. So that crowdfunding could be, hey, you know, I'd really like this person who's written some great courses before to write something new in this area so that we can all have access to it. So that's his list. And I've thought about it in the same way, but I thought this would be easier to get us going and thinking. And so my goal is to stop talking in about 2 minutes and to have you guys take the pieces of paper in front of you and talk amongst yourselves and start thinking about what you'd like to see, what would be important to you, maybe even what's not important to you, because that's always important in design too, right? Design is not necessarily what's in it, but what's not in it. So think about those things and, you know, be influencers. You know, help us put this together. And what we'll do is we'll wander around because there's several of us here, and Martin will be here in a moment too. And think about what you'd like to see and how it would look. You know, what does it mean to find a community of practice? What does it mean to find a mentor? You know, how great if we could find retired teachers who aren't in the classroom every day, but they are at Moodle.net, and they could be communicating with you and helping you do things. What does it mean to find a collaborator? How would you do that? Is there like an area at the site where you ask for support on building a type of course? If so, you know, if that seems valuable to you, write it down. You know, maybe even draw something if you want, storyboard it, whatever. We just would love to understand what it is that you're thinking about that. What does it mean for you to find reusable materials or to find new ideas? You know, are you the type of teacher who really loves teaching kind of the same way every year? Or do you just break your back trying to do something new every year? And if so, where do you find those ideas? Where do you find the books that are going to inspire you next? How do you find training if you're going into new areas? How do you find approaches to problems? How do you think about your course from different learning perspectives? And we've been speaking about the different ideologies that we see. You know, so if you're at an academic school and you want to do something that's more learning-centered, what kinds of shifts do you make? And who can help you do that? We even thought, you know, maybe Community 2.0 is not only a place where you construct a reputation, where people are like, oh, I always trust, you know, David for this. Michael has always done really great work, and he's the person I'm going to ask. And so, you know, that seems important, but maybe it also makes sense to have a portfolio there of your work. Maybe not. This could be a LinkedIn, you know, which is really more about the practice of teaching, which is really supported by evidence of open source badges that have indicated that you have done work that's been valuable to make you knowledgeable. So these are some of the ideas. We know you have more. Do you have any questions about this process? I think it's going to be fun. I'd like to take maybe 20 minutes of you working, and then we'll have some microphones, and we'll walk around, and if you could select a reporter that could then, you know, share back some of the things you've come up with. That would be really valuable. Okay, so blow up Moodle in your mind for a minute. Write down what you want. This is what you really, really want and what you think would make a huge difference because it's worth it. You know, I think whenever you're doing something as big as Moodle, you don't compromise if you have to. It builds a thing that's going to make a difference. And that's not going to be known by developers. It's going to be known by teachers. It's going to be known by administrators. And it's going to be known by the users of it. And so that's why we're taking time around the world to ask at Moodle Moots, what is it that you want? How can we do this? And if you're very, very interested, you know, we'll just keep you involved in other ways as well. Okay, thank you so much. I'll be running around at your tables and looking forward to seeing what you come up with.